Hey everyone, this is Wacky Jim here at Virtua Bros. We're gonna do another VF and chill. This will be volume 4, and I'm gonna be trying out Shun D. So we'll start real soon.
Nugget.
Oh my gosh. Hello everyone. That chat, a little big, isn't it? Change that.
should do it. Okay, how is everyone doing tonight? Hello, zombie guy. So Segalacious is here with me. Right when we turned the intro on, he had some relatives come over to visit his baby, so they crashed the party, unfortunately, but he will be with us, and we're still going to go ahead and stream. So, yep, I can talk to him, I can hear him, but you guys just won't be able to hear him. Otherwise, yeah, people will be talking, the baby might be screaming, you know. So, first things first, this is my first time actually playing Virtua Fighters on the stream, isn't it? No, that's not true. We played Virtua Fighter 2, that's right. It's the first time me playing Final Showdown on the channel. So, I've been playing this game on and off, not as much as Segalacious. Today, we're going to be trying out Shun D. I usually play like Kage or Lao, but Shun D I'm feeling like today because he's a pretty alright dude.
You want me to play Sarah Bryant?
Oh, I haven't learned anything about her, but you know what? If we got time for this stream, which we'll probably do for like, what, an hour or two? Yeah. Okay, at least an hour. We'll definitely pick up on some Sarah. So we'll just go through the training mode with Shun real quick. For those of you who haven't played this game that much, or at all, or even have played Shun D at all, just to show what goes on. So his main mechanic is the drinking, which is the first thing that this game shows you. You drink. And every time you drink, it says on the wiki you get like a 0.75% damage increase. And you do get some speed when you get drunk enough, too, but I'm not sure how the speed's calculated. So you drink, and what drinking does is it gives you more moves. But these are your basic ones that don't require any drinks. You get the punch, 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 and then he's got a normal punch, punch, punch kick. Sorry if you can hear my arcade stick there. And then he can do stuff like punch, 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 kick, and then cancel it into a drink instead. And then he goes into the stance. Yeah, so he's a pretty alright dude. And then you can go punch, punch, back punch, 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 back punch, cancel into a drink. And then, yep. And you can do a drink into a punch or a drink into a kick, which I really like too. Yeah. That's why Sonic Mario's like, time to get drunk, guys. So yeah, he's with it. Sonic Mario knows what's going on and he'll probably be able to help us out. So let's see here. So we can do punch, punch, back, punch, punch. So the more drinks you have, where it says four or more drinks, the more it opens up Shundi's vast, vast move pool, which he's got probably more than a lot of the other characters, if not the most. It is pretty massive. Like I don't know where it ends or begins. Honestly, it's so huge. But anyway, we'll go ahead and go this way. So we can do punch, 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 and then back and cancel into a drink, and then we're backwards. So that's cool. I'm still learning this. So punch, punch, kick. Oh, this is cool. So he gets a punch, punch, kick, kick. It's a low to high, which is pretty nice on PvP. AI doesn't fall for it at all, but against players, it's really nice. And all you need is like four or more drinks. When you have six drinks, you'd go PPKG, and then you fall on the ground. Now, although falling on the ground does make you lose a drink, it's pretty good to confuse your opponent. So it's pretty nice. You can go punch, punch, kick, kick, like it does show us here. You can go punch, punch, kick, kick, punch, punch, kick, kick, and then fall. Pretty neat. PK and back to turn around. Oh, that's neat. And then you could just see you later. D all the way G.
Oh, okay. So Segalacious is notifying me. Sorry, say something. D all the way. Oh, okay. Okay. Nice to meet you, D. Let's see. The punch, he's got a regular punch. He's got a pretty neat elbow. It's actually a twofer. The elbow's pretty nice. So you can elbow drink and then punch again, or elbow drink kick. The kicks are high, which I don't like, so I typically just go for the punch. Back P, drink. That's pretty cool. Back PP, back PP, back. Back court. This is a nice one. So that's plus a few frames on the first hit, and then you get punch, 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 which is really nice. Then you can go punch PK, punch K, cancel, drink, whatever. Like, he's just got so much stuff. He is drinking Shunny Delight. Sorry. Shunny D. That's what the thumbnail on the stream's gonna be, in case anyone's missed it. 4GP. Some of these are a little hard to do. Yeah. I did just barely start playing this guy, as I mentioned before. So he's complicated, but my gosh, he's fun. Yeah, I really do want to get good with this guy, because I'm just having so much fun with him. He's got some nice... Oh, that's because she's laying down. That's why. You can fake him out. You can actually dodge something, drink, and then hit him with like a back whatever. I'm not familiar with all the meta on this guy yet. But yeah, if you've got 10 or more drinks, like, you've won half the game already with this guy. He's just so good. Fun. See, and you can grab when you're on the ground too. I love that. Such a cool guy.
Got Wacky Jim on the sticks. Yeah, you could probably hear my stick. I hope it's not too loud, guys. Oh, okay. So, kicks are quite slow, but if you hold it... Yeah, he's turning red from all the Shunny D and getting done this... Sorry, that was pretty poor taste. Was that a minute? What was it? Oh, that's all high. But, you know, it's a launch, so... No, that's a true... So, how many drinks can Shun have? Up to 40. I don't think you'll ever realistically see 40. But you'll just be really strong and never run out. Like, you'll probably die before you run out of beer, actually, at that point. Okay. I think the damage caps at a certain amount, maybe 14 or 15. I'm not sure. The rest of it's just... Oh my gosh, his walking speed gets pretty bad. But his speed, as you can see, is much better. But yeah, every time you get a knockdown, even if you knock yourself down, watch that, it's at 31, now it's at 30. Every time you hit the ground, it kills your buzz a little. Yeah, so this live stream, we're basically just chilling with Shunny Delight. Not really to show off how good I am with learning the guy and having a lot of fun. Curl up, cuddle, and BF and chill. Oh, I like this back kick, because you can go back kick, then into this stance, and then roll up, grab him. Yep, or you can just drink while you're on the ground. They can only hit you low unless you're moving. See? How can you say no to this character? Like, I'm pretty sure if everybody saw what Shun D could do before they saw his character icon, everybody would be playing this. Know what I mean? Okay, I'll max him. Wants me to max him out. You don't explode or anything, but it would be nice. Yeah. Oh, this is a nice one. Are you like hut, or you like poke back? Oh, dang it, that freezer. Sorry, I'll be right back, folks. Sorry, that dang freezer, the alarm on it, the alarm battery is dead, and so, like, every few hours, it will just do this obnoxious beep. Yeah. Oh, yeah, he's got a Lao kick, or, you know, what's that kick called again? Yeah, the Senpuga. He's got a Senpuga. It's great. A little slower, but yeah, it's a very saucy kick, Segalacious is saying. But it's a Senpuga, and it puts you into back stance. You just grab people while he's backwards. He's got Segalacious is saying Senpuga doesn't put you in back stance, but Shun, because he's such an advanced character, he does. And then you can just roll away if it doesn't work, if they don't react in time, you know. It is high though, so it's basically a whiff punish. Down forward kick. What was that? Oh yeah. That's a true combo. Down back kick. Down back kick. Oh, okay. So, Segalacious pointed out to me that your drinks go down gradually. Yeah. You know. And it's not fermented rice, it's Shunny D. He's got his own drink, he invented it. That's why he's 90 years young and still kicking. This is nice. He's got a natural low-high. Then you can lay down on the ground. PK is pretty nice because it puts you into this stance. And while you're not plus, you can cancel part of the startup of the stance animation to just lay on some pressure, which is pretty nice. And it's mostly mid stuff too. So they will have to block it. You can do a grab too. No. A poke punch. You can't move either, which is kind of. So, I'm not a big fan of that stance, but I can see it's used. This move. This is his real move. This is the move everyone talks about. It dodges highs. It sidewinds some side attacks, I think, to dodge around it. And you get 5 drinks. And it knocks down. So good when you can punish someone. This is a hard one to do. It's not hard to do. You just push P before he drinks. You can get some combo stuff going. I'm not very good at it yet. But, you know. Yeah. Yeah, it is a cool headbutt. And then there's that, which... That's... Okay, I guess. I don't know. You lose beer, you get knocked down, you're both in neutral again. I guess it's good if you see him on the defensive side and you just want to be safe, and then you're knocked down, they can't punish you very easily. So, Race to Nowhere. I know that you're ogling Dural, but she's Kage's mom, and so he doesn't appreciate that. Although she's not married anymore, so she's a grown woman. Oh, that was bad. Okay. Oh yeah, you can go into this saucy little sentence. That move is good. It's Kage's headbutt without the roll startup. Yep, eight or more. So you'll have to get up there if you want to be winning. Let's see. Oh, and then you can go into this stance, and then you can grab people. And then, yeah. That's a hard one to do, because you have to hit grab immediately, and I got lucky on that one. Oh, yeah, some of this stuff you won't see a whole lot unless, like, somebody's really stomping on some. Yeah, he does have a really big. This is a really good move for when people are minus in their own block strings. You've successfully blocked it, or if you're like +3 to +5, just do that move. It will. It hits mid, so it's really versatile. If people are trying to sidestep, if they're going the wrong way, it will. You know, it'll track them. I enjoy it. You can hold it to get into this stance too. That's new to me, so. Yep, you can be like hot, yeah. You can grab with it too. So you can go like ha, and then if they block, you can walk forward and I don't know. Pretty situational, I guess. Oh yeah, he's got a get away from me move. So if people are rushing you down, just tell him like, hey man, step off. I got guns. anyway. Yep. What? Oh wait. Oh yeah, you can fake it, I guess. Hard to do. KGP. Oh, I didn't realize you could do that. Okay. That's cool. This is a nice one, because it will low crush, and then it hits mid. So, gotta block it high. And a lot of times, people have sneaky low attacks. So you'll counter this a lot anyway, and just be like, maybe like this, and then that. He's a fun character, right? And stance. Yeah, if you have six or more drinks. But you don't necessarily need the drinks, because you can get in this stance and then just go to town on them. This is not the greatest move, I think. It's just so slow. It will catch people sidestepping, though. There's that. Kind of deep. Here's his launcher, which is pretty nice. It's nice and fast. That move. Go into the stance. Just grab their booty and shake them. Backflip. Oh, whoops. Hold up. What am I doing? Oh, yeah, his dodges. He's got some pretty crazy dodge stuff. He's like, come on, dance with me. Dance with me. Dance this way. Yeah. So if it's good at making people whiff. Like, it's good for whiff punishing if you really read people, I guess. Oh, that's Segalacious talking to people. Okay. Should he buy Burning Rangers or Saturn Bomberman? I thought you had Burning Rangers. Oh, he has the Japanese version. Yeah, Bomberman is fun.
Oh, that's how you do it. Okay, so I go into this sit stance a lot, and then I forget how to go into this stance, but you just double tap down. Drink. Get into this stance like this. Stances are pretty easy to get into. Kick. DK. Oh, okay. Oh, that's a launcher, huh? That's a pretty dirty one. I could. Yeah, I should probably start, Segalacious is saying, because, like, we've kind of seen everything he can do. It's just, the rest of it's just, like, stance dancing type stuff, and then maybe some... Okay. He's got some nice throws that can switch sides. So let's do arcade. I'm gonna turn... He wants me to do very hard. Should I do very hard or no? I'm thinking no, because I might be at this a while. Okay, I'll do very hard. Okay, here we go. Let's do Shiny D. I don't have any costumes. Sorry, people. I'm cheap. I will probably get costumes eventually, though. I really wish they would port, like, Virtua Fighter R to, like, PC or something. That'd be so great. I don't see why they couldn't, but Sega just... Whoops. Oh, yeah. Oh, he grabbed me. I heard rumors that there was a rumor for VR. So there's apparently a graphic image for VF6 floating around, but we all know how those go. Somebody makes a nice, legit-looking graphic image, so... Gotta take that with a grain of salt, sadly. I would be hyped for a Virtua Fighter 6. I really would. Start grinding on this game a lot more than I haven't been. We don't have any information, but the rumor is Tokyo Game Show 2019. Oh, did you see me mess with her? Like, three other Nozomis? Or with Shandi? What the... Oh yeah, drink. Oh yeah, that's another thing. Your drinks don't go away at the end of a round, and during the end of the round, you just get some more drinks in. You can drink up to like 3 times if you time it right. Pretty neat. He is a crazy, crazy dude. He really is. I like him, though. I do remember when you used to play me in VF2 as Shundi kids, and you would just clown on me all the time. Good stuff. Oops. Tried to do something cheeky during a block stream. Oh, we got some drinks in already. Oh, I should be drinking. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, I messed that up. Oh no, the wrong way. Oh no, he's got me in the corner. This is where Fuerte shines. Oh, he's not Fuerte, sorry, he's El Blaze. Sorry, people. Aw. Oh! Isn't that deceptively long, this freaking scorpion? I love it.
Segalacious Jr.
Someone. Fussy guy. I like him too because he's got big ol'. Just love. He's good. He'll be a good dad. Oh no, he hit me with a mid somewhere in there. Oh, he does. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Jackie's a bully. See, this is what I was worried about, everyone. Oh, checked him that time. Oh, I, lock button for good. Okay. Oh, we got him. Yeah. Oh man, somebody lay out some cardboard because Shundi's got move. Whoops. Dang it, I whiffed that really hard, didn't I? Ducks. Oh, that hurts a lot. Oh no! I thought he was gonna come in, but he's. Oh, the AI is stone cold. Oh, he's basically Bruce Lee. Ah, shucks. Oh, he got me with some... No, 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 please. Oh. Oh, this is hard. This is absolutely what I was worried about. Oh, he's got so many... Oh, he got me. Oh, man. He's checking me left and right. I don't. Damn.
Next VF lore. Do you want to tell him what the next VF lore is, David?
Or do you want to keep that a secret? Okay. Thinking about doing Leon Raphael. Might be. Yeah, it might take a while, but. Oops. Button. Yeah. It's a little hard too because he's got a baby to feed like every couple of hours. Even at night. That's just how infants are. They're growing, so they use all the calories that they use up. The last one might be like John Coo or something. Oh gosh. He does like him, but You might get a mention in Leon's story, though, because just, oh, wow, I didn't know that wasn't safe on block. Oh, what I was trying to do that, but whatever I did was just as nice. Oh, okay, we got 15 drinks. Ain't no reason we can't do this. Oh, my back. Oh, we got him. How about that punish? Ha, ha, ha. Aha! Oh no! Yeah, how about them? Oh, I couldn't grab him because he... There we go. That's how you win. And then he drinks some more. Even if you've won two rounds, you need to start drinking. Because you never know when it'll end. Patting my butt on you. Virtua Fighter is called a stiff game a lot of times, but really it's just, it's not. It just, like, when you get good, it feels so different. Oh yeah, come on now. Oh, he bull rushed me. Oh gosh, that was a good string. Damn, Jeffrey, come on. Oh no! Oh wow. He got me that time. Shenmue does feel pretty stiff, but what a lot of people don't know is that, if you dodge neutral, the block window is pretty large. Oh yeah. Oh, drink! Drink! Damn, I only got one. Oh, he's got a block opener. That's... Oh my gosh, he's really getting me. Oh! No! Oh, I thought he was gonna come in. It looked like it. I got baited by this incredible AI. Where if Sega worked for the military, they'd be able to make, like, an incredible robot cop. Oh, gosh. Dang it. Oh no. Okay. Oh my gosh. Jeffrey. I didn't think I'd lose to Jeffrey so. Dang. Okay, get some drinks. Oh no. Me with a mid. Yeah, he's a very momentum character. For sure, don't you dare. Gotcha, son. Oh no! I do never sidestep, he's pointing out, and that's because most of the time I'm playing 2D fighting games. Been playing a lot more Guilty Gear at that time. Dang it. Cut. That's a good question. Dural lore. Did you see that? No. Yeah. I'm not too familiar with Jeffrey, so I'm falling for a lot of these strings over and over again. I don't have them quite memorized. Yeah, Virtua Fighter 2 Jeffrey. Oh my gosh, dude. Oh, did you see that sidestep there? Oh. Oh, sir. Oh. You. Oh yeah, that's a tricky one to sidestep. Oh dang, he got me out of the roll, you jerk. Oh. The 2P, I need to start doing the 2P more. Oh, it's hard. You had to put me on very hard, didn't you? I'm working on something for Shenmue. My project is, Segalacious was asking. It's about the death of Ewow. Yeah. It is gonna be a good video and you all love it. I loved it when I was thinking it up. And so I think you guys will like it too. I'm not gonna say what it is yet. Cause I want it to be I was gonna make it a big surprise. Oh my gosh. I don't know what to do against this guy. I was trying something new. I was trying to go for like big whiffs. Dang. There we go. Dang. Oops, he got me then. What? Oh no! I thought he was gonna come in. What's up, Nowhere Heroes? How you doing? He's been sticking with us since the Shenmue streams and back, I think, too, right? Oh no. Damn it, every time I get a drink. Ah! Oh, drink. Oh, those are all high. I keep... What's up, man? I did it. Yes, drink. SCH28. You're probably gonna be helpful to me, but I'm so new at this game, or at this character, that I don't even...
I don't even think I'll be able to learn anything else tonight. I'm a little overwhelmed with what I did learn in the training room still.
Oh, gosh. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh. Oh, no. Dang. That's okay. We got three drinks. We're good. Wow, we're at six again. Oh, that's a back throw. You can't get out of them. Oh, gosh. Oh, Pai Chan.
So up plus GK, yeah, it's my launcher. I know. Oh gosh.
Yep. Oh gosh. How it goes.
Say forward PK. Okay. Up guard plus kick and then PK.
Ah! Forward PK.
This is the wall we've hit and the wall that we've...
Yeah! I did it! Ugh!
Oh geez, she's got some silly strings.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, Pai Chan, leave me alone, you're a bully. I hope your dad dies. Ugh.
Oh.
Oh, she sidestepped me. Oh, I didn't sidestep that enough.
Okay. So Segalacious is saying I need to respect her speed a little more. Yeah.
Oh, get them drinks. Oh no.
Leaving my liver alone, it's already taken a lot of abuse.
No, gosh, dang.
Yeah, we got six drinks. Oh,
That's okay, we didn't take much damage that time. Oh, she touched my belly button and then proceeded to kung fu me some more. Aww. No. Oh, that's a good... Dang. I'll get it. I'm doing better.
I can do it. You guys seen the VFM? Slaps Pi hard in the face and tells her to be silent.
You know, I've seen stuff like that, but not on VF Anime. VP. Oh. Dang. Dang. Diagonal down K.
Just shiny D. Yep.
Ah, dang. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Woo-wee. Oh, that's a good move. Unless she freaking meta reads me and sidesteps it. And then grabs me when I try to sidestep. Oh, I missed her. Oh, damn. Make her miss, and then do a haymaker. Okay.
I've always had trouble with speedier characters.
Nuts. Need to just... Oh my gosh. Dang, how'd she sidestep that thing? Oh my gosh, I got perfected. This is why I didn't want to do very hard. But he made me. That's okay. We're just chilling, right? Chilling. Really? Oh no, please. Why? Why did the I feel like the computer just kind of turned it up. That's not... Right. Spit beer all over her. Oh gosh, no. Oh. Okay, so I'm minus on that low kick even on hit. Right.
Some say they made Akira into a Goku clone? How's that?
Okay. Dang it. Dang. Okay. That doesn't work. No! Oh, wow. Getting wall splatted like crazy. Okay. Hmm. Dude, I can't learn moves in the middle of a match, though. Come on. Damn. Come on. She stays totally defensive, and then every time I push a button or try to grab, she just punches me. She's just input reading me at this point. Okay. Okay. Oh, drink! Drink! Okay. I'd have to watch these replays and see what I did different. But we did it, guys! We beat Pai Chan. And now we fight someone who's even more oppressive. In fact, he's the most oppressive guy in the game. If anything. Freaking grabs and guard breaks. And... Oh, okay. Whoops. Dang. Okay.
Glacius has joined the chat.
All right.
Uh-oh.
Sorry about that, guys. I had people come to visit. It's kind of a big deal when, you know, you lay the baby down to sleep and then the in-laws come over right when we start the stream. And so I couldn't, like, be rude and, like, not, you know, let my in-laws come visit and stuff. So it was just a weird situation. But now I'm here. I'm watching. I've been laughing. I've been LMFAOing. Because I feel Wacky Jim's pain at losing to the very hard computer over and over when you're trying to learn a new character. It's hilarious.
Ah.
Now, I find, Wacky Jim, that Akira is vulnerable to sidestepping to the left. So, like, up. That works quite a bit for me.
Okay. Yeah.
And then, if you're on the other side, then you have to sidestep down.
Oh, gosh, I didn't mean to do that stance there.
Donkey kick. Donkey! Oh. Oh. Oh, man, that's a good throw. Oh, here comes pow, pow, pow. Oh. Yep. What you need is, like, a combo string that you can abuse.
Yeah. I don't have a combo
string. I think that's what SCH28 was trying to teach you.
Okay. What was the exact thing he put in? Because I missed it.
It was something like...
Oh, my gosh.
Well, I don't know. I don't think he actually told you a string. He just was giving you some tools. But then you're like, I can't learn new moves in the middle of the fight. Sure you can. You have to see the stars, Akira.
Damn. Elbow salt.
Right.
Ooh. Ah, that back kick is pretty awful, I guess.
Oh, oh. There you go. Oh, he grabbed him. It didn't do much. See, right there, you could have sidestepped that.
Oh, my God.
If you push up.
Right where?
Hang on. You know where he kind of like hit you and then he jumped to the side and then pushed you or grabbed you? Right there is where you could have sidestepped. If you see him do that, you can punish him pretty good. And actually, these computers, even on very hard mode, they will whiff quite a bit.
Oh, I couldn't sidestep him at all there.
Oof, oof, oof. My friend's custom Akira is called Shakira. He's one tough CPU cookie. Yeah, he can be pretty vicious. I kind of wish that Dural would let you have continues against her, but I mean, it is kind of like tradition to not do that, so I don't know if I would want them to change it.
He's just doing stuff and I just did kick and I'm not drinking when I win. No. What's wrong with me?
That's okay. You'll get there. See right there, when he does that kind of punch, like it's like a down punch, and then he'll sidestep and then try to hit you with something. And you can sidestep it.
I was already dedicated in a move there, though. But I... Come on. Oh, I can't guard break nothing. Oh, this is hard.
Oof.
What's the input for instantly getting like up off the ground? EKG or?
Yeah. I think so. Oh man, I wish I remembered. I haven't played Virtua Fighter in like a month because of the baby. Is it PKG or is it just G? Just to stand up, like neutral stand? Oh boy.
No, well, yeah, just to quickly get up off the ground.
Akira is going to sober you up. Who needs a cold shower when you got that shoulder? Ugh! There you go. Some good drinks.
That shoulder did a ton of freaking damage.
You just got Tetsu'd on counter hit.
Tetsu zonked.
Mm-hmm. Whoa. It's like, Shundi's like, oh, where am I? Welcome to AA, Shundi. Oh, no! Oh! His Alcoholics Anonymous is like getting pummeled in the face. I hope Yu Suzuki gets the chance to work on a new VF. Yeah, CSTOH, didn't he say he was open to that idea? He said that in an interview recently. He was like, yeah, I would totally be up for that. He said he'd just have to contact Sega and talk to them about it, but he would do a new Outrun. He would do a new Space Harrier. He would do a new Virtua Fighter. He's up for it. He's ready to go, man. I love that about Yu Suzuki. Would Sega be open to the idea? I want to say the money would be good, but I don't know if Sega likes money very much or not. They make somewhat unintuitive business decisions sometimes. Yeah.
They like Shadow the Hedgehog and Rouge the Bat.
But that's there might Sega be reasons. Well, there might be reasons why they do that. When I was talking with Adam Korolik, he was like, look, man, you got to understand with Sega, the corporate side of things is everybody wants to eat the sausage. Nobody wants to see how it's made. If you see the way the video game industry really works, it can make you very cynical. Mm. So,
yeah,
I think, I think that we need to give Sega some credit because they've done some solid things lately with some of their IPs. So it seems like they are trying. They're putting forth an effort. I mean, we got Shenmue 1 and 2, the HD re-release. It wasn't the best, but it wasn't the worst either, and it exists. I mean, that's a huge deal. It's all about the money. Yeah, it really is, SCH. They'd rather do another Yakuza. I like Yakuza, though. I'm okay with that. Money is the root of all evil, though it is the survival of the earth. Actually, I would say the love of money is the root of all evil.
Mm-hmm.
Money is just neutral. Money's a tool.
Yep.
Just like Akira, who is also a huge, huge tool. Ooh! Did you see that one-frame knee he tried to hit you with? And he blocked it.
Damn.
Yeah, I know SCH28, but at least like with the Shenmue port, they're showing interest in a franchise that was so dead it wasn't even funny.
Yeah.
They are chill about copyright. That's a good point. I like that as well. But that means they don't care about their IPs. Possibly. Probably not. I don't know. I do like that they're chill about their IPs, though. That is nice. Ooh. Okay, who would win in a fight, Kiryu or Ryo? I would put it this way. Who would win in a fight, Kiryu or Akira? And I would say Akira. And so if you let Ryo develop himself to his fullest potential, then he would beat Kiryu. Now, Ryo in Shenmue 3 versus Kiryu, that'd be a tough one. I'm not sure. Yeah, Nintendo, they do copyright strike a lot, but they've actually slackened that a little bit, haven't they, Wacky Jim?
They have, ever since people stopped, like, just outright quit buying games for the Wii U because they couldn't stream any of them.
Well, Yeah, they've started to modernize a bit.
Yeah. They took it off when Smash Brothers came out. Like, people wanted to stream Mario Kart a bunch, and they didn't like that.
You'll notice, by the way, sorry, back to the Virtua Fighter thing here, Wacky Jim. Whenever you put distance between you and Akira, he'll do this forward crouching dash where you just go 3-3-3-3-3 like really fast, and you can do it too if you want to close in. But Dural will do that to you really bad. It's disgusting. Man, I wish I knew some moves for Shun Di.
I don't know.
I'm not very good at Virtua Fighter, but sometimes I'm decent at cheesing the computer.
Yeah, I'm definitely hitting a wall right now.
That's all right.
Ugh.
All you need is more alcohol.
I do, but it's hard to get it a drink anything when he's punching you in the face.
But what if they brought a Yakuza character into Virtua Fighter? You know, I thought about that. I thought it would be pretty cool. But the more I thought about it and the more I talked with SCH28, I really think it would be more appropriate to put Yakuza and Shenmue characters instead of into Virtua Fighter. I think it would be better to put them into, like, a Fighter's Mega Mix 2. If we're going to do crossovers, let's make a crossover game and do it like that. I think that would be cool. I made a VF2 PC video and got a copyright claim by a disc label company for a vaporware song that is just a slower version of the name entry music. What in the heck? That's messed up, man. And lately, the Virtua Fighter anime, the TMS anime people have really been striking people down really hard. They tried to take down some of my Virtua Fighter lore videos. I got the Akira one back up. That was sad, though, because my first upload of that had, like, a lot of views. It was like, I don't know what it was, 15,000 views or something like that. And then it stopped going up. I'm like, why did it stop going up? And I realized it had been blocked in every country, so...
Every country, sheesh.
Yeah, the whole world. So I did a re-upload, and then that was up for like 5 minutes, and they blocked it again. So then I did another re-upload, and it stayed. So now I've got to fix the Jackie Bryant one, get all the Virtua Fighter lores up there. It's a bummer, man. I put a lot of hours into those.
Oh.
You don't know how numb my bum cakes became sitting for hours slaving over this computer. Try to
I've
make
got
Virtua Fighter lore 17 videos.
17 drinks and I'm losing.
Oh!
I was trying to.
Ah. There. Right there. When he does that punch, that. See? And you can dodge it.
Yeah. It's so easy to react to, isn't it?
I got pretty good at it after a while, but it took time.
I can't see anything coming.
Just relax. You must
okay. Find must get to Dural and at least get a game over on her. Oh.
Can you try doing a forward K?
Like that?
There you go. Hey! I don't know if that leads to a stance in Final Showdown. It did in VF4 Evo.
Oh, drink. Okay, good.
Okay. A VF6 with a story mode. So, Jalen, I think if you did a VF6, I don't know. I almost think maybe we shouldn't do a VF6. I think we should do a VF reboot. And just combine all the stories of 1 through 5 together and then put 6 in as well.
That's what Dead or Alive did on the 3DS. I liked it.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh. And then you could take all the movie cutscenes and like modernize them and put in new ones. I mean, like just draw on the lore. Mm-hmm. I hope Sega does that. You could make the lore so cool if you actually spell it out for people a little bit more, because it's just got. You didn't dodge it again. That's okay, though, bro. You're doing your best. Scorpion kick. Elbow. Rimon Chochu is a powerful technique that kills alcoholic elderly men.
Gosh, where's my phone?
The damage from the elbow to the solar plexus makes his alcohol digestible.
Quaffable? Unquaffable?
Yeah, unquaffable. That's a good one. If not VF Fighters Mega Mix versus Tekken, oh, that would be pretty neat. Okay, so I talked about this with a guy named Mikel Casanova a long time ago, but do you think that a Virtua Fighter crossover with Tekken could really work? Because Tekken is left punch, left kick, right kick. And Virtua Fighter doesn't really do that. So, like, it's kind of similar to Street Fighter in a way, because when you switch sides, the punch and kick, like, it's like you've got, like, symmetry, you know what I mean?
Yeah, they'd have to make a totally different game to accommodate for both of them.
Yeah, and so then if you gave Virtua Fighter characters a left punch and a right punch, it's like, are they still really Virtua Fighter characters? And if you didn't, would they really fit in the Tekken universe? Like, that'd be hard to do. I think that there'd be just kind of incompatible. As much common ground as Tekken and Virtua Fighter have, I feel like they're fundamentally quite different. Their hearts gel together.
Yeah.
Bob asks, you guys watch a lot of animes? Sometimes I do. I like animes. I just have to find one I really get into, and I binge it like crazy. Depends on the characters. They shouldn't use all Tekken characters. Oh, sounds like my baby's awake, so I'll be back. Let me mute myself. Or actually, you should probably mute me, Wacky Jim.
I mean, you have a button on Skype, so...
Okay, then.
With the microphone.
But then you won't hear me, but very well.
Dang it. It doesn't work. I should just play Akira, huh, guys? Tekken characters share more lists. Yeah, I mean, I think maybe someone like Lau could work, but then if they put in Lau in a Tekken game, it'd basically be another like Fang, right?
I don't know if Fang is quite the same as Lau. Design wise, they look sort of similar.
Yeah.
Oof, you're just sitting on the floor and he just kicks you right in the face.
I give up.
Wham, wham, wham. Right there, punish.
Oh, I was trying.
That's okay.
Really trying.
Yeah, you just need to get a little bit more familiar with some of his moves. I don't know, does he have like a diagonal down forward P plus, no, K plus G or something? Is that what that is, the breakdance? You could try some of that. Yeah, try some of that stuff when he whips, when he misses. Right? Yeah, like right there when he goes to do that. Ouch, that looked like it hurt. Right there. Oh, you want to dodge? I know you were drinking, but... Is Shun a bad matchup for Akira? I don't think so.
Ah...
I think that a lot of people do really well against Akira with Shun.
Oh, yeah. If you guys missed it on the 30th, I did. I haven't watched the top 8 for it already yet, but Level Up Live has a Virtua Fighter tournament for Evo. It's pretty nice. There's a really good Shun player in that one.
That's cool. Oh, Pros and Cons guy says, hey, Virtua Bros, if you could reboot Virtua Fighter, how would you do it? So what I would do is, as we said earlier, I would take all of the storylines between Virtua Fighter 1 to Virtua Fighter 5, and I would create a story mode for each individual character. So when you played as Akira, you would... It would even like use like some of the stuff from Virtua Fighter Kids as like his prologue or his introduction to his character. And during those cinematics, it'll give you like these QTE exercises or something like of that nature, to where it teaches you some of his moves, like a, kind of like a tutorial, but you get a story mode in the tutorial.
Did you see that?
Woo, you got him. Nice one, bro. And I think that when you did that, when you explore each character's storyline through the five tournaments that we've established so far, you could do fun stuff like with Jackie Bryant. I would make a mini game of Virtua Racing. With Jeffrey McWild, I would do like a Sega Bass Fishing mini game. With Kagemaru, maybe like some kind of shinobi thing. And yeah, I think it would be really cool. That's kind of my thoughts for doing something like that.
Okay. I found a good like poke punish thing. Back PP. I hold back and then I PP on him.
Oh, okay. By the way, you can throw right after doing a punch. Normal punch, grab.
Oh.
Nice.
Oh, dang it.
Huh.
Hmm.
Ooh.
He's just
like
waltzing.
In Sarah Bryant's storyline, you could have her being brainwashed by Judgment Six. And like have them be doing experiments on her, and like the experiments could be like her tutorial.
Oh, okay.
Like you have to fight like...
Oh, I thought you were talking like a mini game. You were playing as a Judgment Six scientist and torturing Sarah.
Yeah, that'd be cool. Yeah, something like that. That'd be really neat. Do you guys watch the Mari show? I have not watched that. I wonder if Yu Suzuki would make a new VF more like 3. After all, he didn't have much influence on 4's gameplay. SCH28, do you prefer 4's gameplay or 3's? Final Showdown has good balance. Yeah, it does. It really does. A lot of people were pretty disappointed with Final Showdown compared to the arcade. I talked with the guy who runs the channel at I Play Sega. He was making some comments online and chatting with me a little bit. And he was saying how people were disappointed with Final Showdown because it's basically like a bare bones Virtua Fighter 5R. Like they just stripped a lot of the cool lighting effects out of it. They got rid of like, you know, fighting in shallow water. That was even in Virtua Fighter 5 Online. And they did all that just so that it would fit as a, you know, a downloadable game for the Xbox 360. So in hindsight, that was unfortunate. But at the same time, the character models do look a bit improved, like polygon-wise and texture-wise. And I like it. I think it's pretty fun. I enjoy Final Showdown quite a bit for what it is, even though I know the arcade's probably a lot better, but I never got to play the arcade version, so maybe I'm just deprived. SCH28, I recall an interview with Yu Suzuki where he stated that he felt he may have made Virtua Fighter 3 too difficult, too hard. Like too steep of a learning curve. And so they were trying to rectify that with Virtua Fighter 4. I think the mainstream consensus for most people is that Virtua Fighter 4 is really good. Oh. I've heard a lot of people say Virtua Fighter 4 Evolution is the best, and then other people say, no, it's Virtua Fighter 5R is the best. So it's interesting. Personally, for me, I love Virtua Fighter 2. I think that one might always be my favorite. I just have so much nostalgia for it. But the worst Virtua Fighter game. The worst Virtua Fighter game. Do you have a thought on this, Wacky Jim?
I haven't played 4, so it's hard to say.
Well, I'm not even thinking any of the mainline Virtua Fighter games. I'm thinking like a CG portrait series for the Sega Game Gear or something like that. There's Virtua Fighter Kids. There's that Sega iToy game, but I think the Sega iToy game was pretty cool. There's Virtua Quest. I don't know. What did you think of Virtua Quest, Wacky Jim?
I haven't even ever seen it or anything.
James.
I haven't. Have I?
You watched me beat it on a stream.
Oh, yeah. That's the GameCube one. Oh, okay.
Yes.
I liked that one,
actually.
Well, it's
on PS2 also.
Sorry, I thought you were talking about like the RPG thing that they were trying to make that Shenmue was originally supposed to be.
Oh, no. But I guess you could kind of consider Virtua Quest a Virtua Fighter RPG reboot in a way. It's like a Virtua Fighter RPG without the Shenmue influence. Ooh. All those blockies. VF3 Team Battle has been getting pretty popular at Japanese Arcade recently. Oh, that's pretty cool. I really enjoy Virtua Fighter 3 a lot. And I've got to credit SCH28 for that, because I gave it more of a chance because of what he told me about it. And I do really enjoy it. I think it's a really fun game. It's kind of hard to play with the Dreamcast gamepad, though. Holy cow.
Yeah.
But you got him once. If you can get him once, you can get him twice. Oh, yeah. See, Bob likes Virtua Fighter 2 the most as well. See? There you go. Virtua Fighter Pachinko game.
Oh, maybe. Gosh. What am I supposed to do after that?
The 4th 3TB World Cup at Mikado happened recently, and there were 76 players. Hey, not a bad turnout for such an old game. Yeah, you need to keep your distance with Akira, says S. Garcia, and I think that could help.
I'm trying, but now I'm cornered.
But see, when he closes the gap, you got to sidestep.
Oh, shit.
And it's okay, just relax. It's okay if you lose. Like right now, bam. Okay. But feel his rhythm. Like, Akira has a rhythm, and you can start sidestepping it and punishing. There. Sometimes what I'll do is I'll sidestep and just grab him. Right there, sidestep. Sidestep. Nice. Ooh, that was weird.
Oh, no.
Oh, sidestep.
Oh, my God.
Sidestep. When you're on the right side, try pushing down to sidestep.
Okay.
Oh, VF2 is your worst VF game. Your favorite would be VF5. Bob, come on, man. VF2 is a classic. How could you? Let's see. Of course, those 5 FS tournaments are another story. Nothing beats the Tribe Cups. Those get over 500 players. Yeah, that's pretty cool, to beat Tribe Cups. Virtual Bros, what was up with that crazy emotion-hating scientist lady? Was she even in the VF story? What was the point of her There's a lot in the Virtua Fighter anime that's non-canon, but you could just think of her as part of the Judgment Six, because the Judgment Six, you know, they're behind the Dural program, they're behind the World Fighting Tournaments, and they have scientists that do experiments on people. Hey, Silver-Haired Devil, what's up, man? Yeah, speaking of underrated fighting games, you've got Kato Chojin, Back Alley Brutal for the original Xbox. Cool game. I played it. I liked it. It's got a demo for Shenmue 2 on it as well. That's a Seiichi Ishii game. And Seiichi Ishii was very instrumental in the first Virtua Fighter, so... A lot of times with Akira, you can almost sidestep him, like, first thing. Like, he'll throw a huge, hard attack out, and you can just, like, whoop! You can just push up and sidestep a lot of times. Right there, sidestep. There! Got it. But don't stop. Once you start, just punish him hard. Sidestep.
Ooh. Ah. Okay.
You starting to get it? Get the rhythm, bro?
Kind of.
Yeah, you're getting more sidesteps in.
Okay. Oh, that sidestep.
Who needs block when you've got dodge? Gohan! You need to dodge!
Okay.
You know what's funny? Yu Suzuki mentioned 3 was hard, while 4 made combos easier and long. It also introduced a lot of execution-heavy stuff. Yeah, that is a kind of interesting point, I suppose.
Dang, too soon.
Have you ever done a triple evading multi-throw escape with guard? No, I haven't. Okay, I love VF2 now. You're happy, Segalacious? You're just saying that, Bob. You don't mean it. I don't believe you. And that's in 4, huh? Nope. Yeah, I've never done that.
Jeez.
You know what's cool in Virtua Fighter 4 is Wolf has this grab where he, like, wraps his arms around your arms and, like, breaks your elbows and he swings you around and throws you. I wish that throw was still in Virtua Fighter 5. I feel like Wolf Hawkfield is kind of nerfed in Virtua Fighter 5 compared to 4. I feel like he was really tough in 4. Am I wrong? I don't know. I mean, he's still really tough in 5. Don't get me wrong. You can do just fine with him. But I noticed some differences. So. I have done that a few times, but it's hard. I can usually pull off 2 multiple throw escapes. Hmm.
Oh. Just grabbed me. Damn it. Oof.
Boom, boom, boom. There. Get him. There you go. Yeah.
Oops.
Now, if you wait, when you have that much distance, he'll start just, like, throwing stuff out there, and you can punish him. Because he's a dumb computer. And you can cheese him.
Okay. I'm not good at 3D games.
It's okay. It takes time.
Yeah, I got you that time, sucker.
Yeah. Mmm. That's called the smell of my armpits, Akira.
Oh.
Yeah, Wacky Jim's playing on very hard. Oh yeah. Okay, get ready. See how he whiffs? Okay, get ready to sidestep.
Oh, I tried.
Right there.
Dang.
Of course, you were on the floor, so you couldn't, but...
Oh, man. He did an elbow assault, and then I dodged it from, like, really far away. Yes, yeah. Yes.
That was sick. Nice. Dodge. Ooh, that knee. Oh, you almost went over the edge. Dodge.
No, I don't want to be on this side. Okay.
Oh, jeez.
No, up.
Yeah!
Drink.
That was sick.
Okay.
Okay, you've got 10 drinks.
Which means I can do this. Damn it.
Dodge.
Okay, when he does the two low kicks, I dodge right? Oh, shit. Oh, what was that? Damn. I might call it after this one, guys. I'm sorry.
Mad at me for yelling dodge too loudly and waking up the baby. That was my bad.
How did you wake up the baby?
I was yelling dodge. Wacky Jim, you can't give up.
I wanna.
In Final Showdown, there are four possible outcomes to a throw. You can only cover one option out of four. If there are... In three, there are five directions and six outcomes if you count neutral throw. You also need to input two directions if throw is a circular to escape. Yeah, I feel like throws were harder. Okay, does that mean they were harder to escape in Virtua Fighter 3?
That's a string, I guess. I don't know. I tried to grab him after he whiffed that double fist. And then I just got shouldered.
Try to grab on sidestep more.
I'm trying. I just got to sidestep first.
Well, yeah, you're not. But sometimes he'll do that, so. There you go. Okay, look out. Don't go back, go sideways.
I didn't mean to do that.
Get him, boy. Oh, you could have kicked him in the face.
I don't.
Oh, it's okay. Sometimes what happens too is you gotta fight the computer, get your butt kicked, and then you go back and go through the command training again. And you just do that back and forth over and over until you find what works for you. And then once you can beat the computer on very hard, you're officially a beginner. VF3TV's throw system is more like a gamble. It's all about mind games. It's like a thinking man's game. There's so much going on all the time. You need to keep track of it. Yeah, I could see that. I feel like it is a lot easier to escape throws in Final Showdown, which kind of nerfs Wolf a little bit. But back in the VF2 and VF3 days, people called throws cheap. They felt throwing characters were very cheap in Virtua Fighter games. So, I don't know. You can never make everyone happy.
People tend to hate grapple characters in fighting games too, though.
Oh, what was that, Wacky Jim?
People just hate grapple characters in fighting games, period.
Yeah, they get mad. It's cheap.
Because they're freaking weeb karate people lose to these swole chads and they get mad.
So did you hear that Mr. 357's in the chat now, Wacky Jim?
Oh, hey, dude. What's up?
Ooh. Oh, Shunny D and rum. Yum, yum. It's a flavor I just thought of. Shunny D and rum. It's so good, I can't get enough.
Oh, he can charge that?
Yeah, he can charge it. Oh, there you go. See, he just one frame need, but you sidestepped it. Okay, now you're on the right side, so when you sidestep, push down. Okay, now you gotta push up when you sidestep.
Oh, I did! And then he freaking had like some kind of string, I guess.
Not really a string, he just kinda reacted quickly.
Damn.
There you go.
Oh, I didn't mean to grab. Ooh. I just fingers panicked.
When he broke your grab, he hit you into the wall. That was crazy.
I hit forward and PK, not PKG game.
VF4 series is like the Execution Master game. Four also has six outcomes, but you can cover three throws if you're good at execution.
I can't sidestep for crap.
Oh, okay. Interesting. I still cannot do Akira's, what's it called? Like, he's got the Hogeki Unshin Sokosho, and then he's got that other one, that really hard input command that's, it's like a long string. I cannot do it. It's got some weird long name. That's...
Oh, that hits low, I guess?
That has always bothered me. I have trouble doing that. I've never been able to pull it off completely. C.S. Garcia, thanks for stopping by, man.
Sorry I didn't beat Dural in time. Oh, gosh. Oh, that's a string. Oh, gosh, what was that?
Ooh, you, speaking of the Hogeki Unshin Sokosho. Bam. You know what can be helpful sometimes against Akira as well? Ooh, yeah. There you go. Oh.
No!
Oh, he's like, kicking the tummy.
Yeah.
When he's getting off the ground, if you jump up in the air, like backwards,
mm-hmm.
jump backwards or jump towards him, sometimes you can jump over his legs and kick him.
Yeah, ouch.
Oh, you just got tetsued. Ooh.
Know how to play games.
Tylord Stevenson's here.
Hi.
Is Wacky Jim there? Wacky Jim is on the sticks. I'm just watching and talking.
Can't do this today. I'm all petered out.
Throws are not cheap. Throws are supposed to break an opponent who blocks. What is cheap is True Ogre from Tekken Tag 1, who can tech grab with a 60 damage unblockable. Yeah, you'll have that. I say screw this game. I'm playing on very easy, says Bob.
I want to. Oh my gosh.
Okay. Here's the deal, Wacky Jim.
Mm-hmm.
You're no longer Shun D. You're Master Chen.
Oh.
There you go. And you're not fighting Akira. You're fighting Ryo. Oh, that one frame knee. It hurts so much. It launches. Okay, you could have dodged that. Oh! There you go. That's the stuff. Nice.
No!
I'm not sure what Shundi's jumping kicks are like. Oh, nice, bro. You got this.
Ooh, I should have drank some more. Ah.
I finally tried VF4 Evo the other day, and I didn't like it as much as I expected. Having a guard button is pretty outdated by today's standards, in my opinion. I've become too spoiled by Tekken 7.
Yeah.
Yeah, Tekken 7, where you just
you push can just nothing stand there and you can block. Yeah.
Blocks. There's a guard button in Virtua Fighter, bro. You gotta.
Think Smash Brothers or Soul Calibur, and you'll get it.
Yeah.
No.
You gotta.
No, I had it.
Oh, you did. See, you're getting close. It's doable, Wacky Jim. Do it again. I think Shun D is more similar to Jianmin from Shenmue 2. Shun's voice actor from 4 voiced Jianmin in the Japanese version. Oh. Okay. Yeah, I could see that. And then you've got pictures of Shun D all over the place at like Manmo Kung Fu and whatnot. Nice. There you go, Wacky Jim. Akira, you've got to see the stars. Find the stars, Akira. You got to dodge that, bro.
I was already in a freaking hit string, dude.
Doesn't matter. Even if he hits you with that first one, while he's sidestepping, you can just sidestep the other attack.
That'll work.
I'm surprised that worked. Oh, that was so cool looking.
No, it grabbed me.
Yeah. There you go. Oh, yeah. Yeah! Be cool. 2P. 2P.
Oh, yeah.
There you go.
I'm done.
Oh, I almost woke up the baby. Sorry. 2P is the way to be. Oh. It's even more interesting if you consider Janmin had a full beard in the beta of Mule. Oh.
Wow. That's a door. Oh, okay. Let's go. I'll shake your metal bouncy booty. Oh, I know what's happening. That so when I do that, standing on one leg and two punches, that's back forward PK, not just forward PK.
Okay, Shundi, this is it. You can sidestep Dural as well. Same way.
Oh, shoot. Who was that?
Ooh, that was Wolf's kick. Or maybe it was Jeffrey's.
I don't know what that was.
Oh, no. You're going to go off the... Ooh. Now she's in Vanessa's stance. She's doing like a Vanessa Jeffrey combo. Oh no. Oh no. Yeah, she's channeling a lot of Jeffrey.
Oh gosh. That's Ooh. Wolf. Isn't it?
No, but you made it. You did it, Wacky.
I made it to Dural and lost, and made it to Dural.
You wanted to quit
beer and became the ultimate warrior.
That's right.
Oh.
Because you know what?
So
here's why you made it to Dural, because sobriety is for quitters, and Shundi is not a quitter.
Right.
Oh, you did it, Wacky Jim. Now you just gotta beat Dural.
Yeah.
And then when you beat Dural, you're a beginner, and you'll get your white belt. To put it more simply, why have a neutral stance in which you don't guard? There's no advantage to it. And games that automatically block you... Wait. Games that auto-block you make you vulnerable when you move forward or to the side anyway.
I have an argument. So there are moves that are plus on block, and then you can do like some kind of grab or mix-up gimmick. There's plenty of ways around guarding.
Not to mention, having a guard button allows you to buffer throw escapes, and it lets you do feinting attacks. Like, you can throw a kick and then cancel out of it when you hit the guard button. I mean, there's plenty of reasons to have a guard button in Virtua Fighter.
Just because
you mess
no...
up the whole game. Yeah. Sorry, go ahead.
Yeah, cross-ups or the lack thereof aren't what make a fighting game deep.
Right.
It's the moves, basically. The moves and the other mechanics surrounding it. Like, Tekken has very, very few cross-ups, honestly. You can pull them off, but for the most part, you are fighting head-to-head. So.
True. Like, Mr. 357 made me think of that movie WALL-E. You know, where all the people are on the spaceship and like they sit in a chair and they're like, robots, do this for me.
Mm-hmm.
They're like, they're playing Tekken. Guard for me, robot. Don't make me push guard button. I'm just joking, Mr. 357. You're not used to pushing guard, and you just got to get used to it.
Yeah.
That's all. Well, that was good, Wacky Jim.
Thanks. I guess.
How do you feel?
I feel defeated and embarrassed.
No.
And
you did it.
And I feel like I want alcohol.
All right. Well, do you want to go ahead and end the stream then?
Sure thing.
Okay. We do have a little outro video prepared for you guys. Don't forget to mute us when you're ready to put it on there, Wacky Jim.
I know.
But in the meantime, friend moves. Be safe. Take care. Keep friends and those you love close to you. And hopefully I'll be able to put out a few videos here and there in the near future. It won't be Virtua Fighter lore for a while just because I don't have the time. How about you, Wacky Jim? What do you got coming up?
I've got a Shenmue thing I'm working on. I've got a few ideas. It's not just going to be one video. Stay tuned.
Sounds good. Have a good night, everybody. Let it go!